Design an ideal Hilbert transformer for the frequency response HD of e power j omega is equal to j when the frequency is greater than or equal to minus pi and less than or equal to 0, and its value is minus j when the frequency is greater than or equal to 0 and less than or equal to pi. Using the rectangular window method for n is equal to 11. So now we are going to design Hilbert transformer using rectangular window method for 11 samples. Okay, in the solution part, first we have to draw the frequency response diagram for the given values. So here its value is plus j when the frequency is from 0 to minus pi, and its value is minus j when the frequency is from 0 to pi. From this diagram we can understand that the Hilbert transformer is an anti-symmetric system. The first step in the design process is to obtain the desired impulse response sequence HD of n. It can be obtained by using the formula HD of n is equal to 1 by 2 pi integration from minus pi to plus pi HD of e power j omega n into d omega. Next we are going to substitute this value of HD of e power j omega. So here the limit is changed. Minus pi to 0 its value is plus j, and 0 to pi its value is minus j. Okay, here we can take this j as a common term. So here it is j by 2 pi integration from minus pi to 0 e power j omega n d omega minus, here it is minus, right? So minus integration from 0 to pi e power j omega n d omega. Consider this as the first equation. So here it is very important point. We are going to use this equation later on. Okay. So after that we are going to integrate with respect to omega. Okay. So this term becomes e power j omega n by j n minus e power j omega n by j n. So we can take this 1 by j n as a common term outside from this bracket. So here we can get the value as j divided by 2 j n pi, and then we can substitute that limits here. E power 0 minus e power minus j n pi. Here minus, the upper limit is pi here. So e power j n pi plus e power j. Actually here it is minus of the lower limit. So already one minus is there. So minus into minus plus. Okay. So next we can divide this j. So this term becomes 1 by 2 n pi. E power 0 is 1. Anything power 0 is 1, correct? So here it is 1 plus 1, 2 minus, we can take this minus outside. So here we can write e power j n pi plus e power minus j n pi. It is in the form of e power j theta plus e power minus j theta is equal to 2 cos theta. So this term can become 2 cos n pi. Okay. Then we can get hd of n is equal to 1 by 2 n pi, 2 minus 2 cos n pi. Here we can simplify the term like this. Okay, so we can get HD of n is equal to 1 minus cos n pi divided by n pi. Here the n value varies from minus infinity to plus infinity. This impulse response sequence is an infinite duration sequence. But we are going to design FIR filter, that is finite impulse response filter. So here the filter coefficients are anti-symmetric about n is equal to 0. Correct? Here the given system is an anti-symmetric one. So anti-symmetric means here we can say the condition as HD of n is equal to minus HD of minus n. Okay? This is the condition for this anti-symmetric system. So next we are going to find out the values of HD of n from minus 5 to plus 5, because we are getting the value as n minus 1 by 2 is equal to 11 minus 1 by 2, that is 5. Okay, so we can have the value like this. So here n is equal to 0 at this point. Okay, so here we can get the values from minus 5 to plus 5 because we are having that length as 11. Okay, so 11 minus 1 by 2 is equal to 5. We can start from minus 5 to plus 5. Here these two are anti-symmetric. So n is equal to minus 1, that value is 1, means example I am saying it is 1 means at n is equal to plus 1, we can have the value as minus 1. Okay, so it is an anti-symmetric one. So this is the condition for that. HD of n is equal to minus HD of minus n. Okay. Next, we are going to find out the finite duration impulse response sequence from this minus 5 to plus 5. So for that we have to take this HD of n is equal to 1 minus cos n pi by n pi. Okay. First we have to start with n is equal to 0 value. For this n is equal to 0, this HD of n value becomes indeterminate. Because if I am going to put n is equal to 0 in this formula, what will happen? So the numerator 1 minus cos 0. Cos 0 value is what? 1. So 1 minus 1, 0. In this denominator, n value is 0 means 0. So 0 by 0 means indeterminate value. For this n is equal to 0 alone, we are going to use the first equation. Okay. HD of 0 is equal to j by 2 pi integration from minus pi to 0 e power 0 d omega minus integration from 0 to pi e power 0 d omega. Because that n value is 0 here, right? So e power 0 is nothing but 1. Okay, so now we are going to integrate with respect to omega. Then we can get the value like this, j by 2 pi omega minus pi to 0 here minus omega of 0 to pi. Substitute that upper limits and lower limits, then we can get 0 minus into minus of pi, that becomes plus pi, correct? Here it is plus pi minus pi plus 0. So pi pi cancel, then we can get the answer as 0. HD of 0 is equal to what? 0. For n is equal to 1, we can directly use that formula. So HD of 1 is equal to 1 minus cos n value is 1 pi by pi. So cos pi value is minus 1. So 1 minus of minus 1 is equal to 2. Correct, minus into minus plus. So 2 pi pi is equal to 0.6366. As we know that HD of 1 is equal to minus HD of minus 1 is equal to 0.6366. Okay. For n is equal to 2, HD of 2 is equal to 1 minus cos 2 pi by 2 pi. That is equal to cos 2 pi value is plus 1. So here we can have 1 minus 1, that value is equal to 0. So HD of 2 is equal to minus HD of minus 2 is equal to 0. Next, for n is equal to 3, HD of 3 is equal to 1 minus cos 3 pi. Cos 3 pi value is minus 1. So we can have 2 by 3 pi, that is equal to 0.2122. That is the answer for HD of 3 and minus HD of minus 3. So next, n is equal to 4. For this, HD of 4 is equal to 1 minus cos 4 pi by 4 pi. Cos 4 pi value is plus 1. So 1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Hence, HD of 4 is equal to minus HD of minus 4 is equal to 0. Then the last value, n is equal to 5. HD of 5 is equal to 1 minus cos 5 pi by 5 pi. That is equal to 1 minus of minus 1 by 5 pi is equal to 2 by 5 pi. That is equal to 0.1273. So we have obtained the finite duration impulse response sequence from minus 5 to plus 5 values. The next step is to obtain the rectangular window sequence that is represented as WR of n. Its value is always 1 from minus n minus 1 by 2 to plus n minus 1 by 2. 0 otherwise. So here we can have this value 1 from minus 5 to plus 5 because the capital N value is 11, right? Here WR of n is equal to WR of minus n. The third step is to multiply the HD of n and then rectangular sequence to get the finite duration sequence, that is H of n. So H of n is equal to HD of n into WR of n. So here the range is from minus 5 to plus 5. So let's start with 0 value. So here n is equal to 0 means H of 0 is equal to HD of 0, WR of 0. So here HD of 0 value is 0 into 1. So we can get the answer as 0. H of 1 is equal to HD of 1 into WR of 1. That is equal to HD of 1 is 0.6366 into WR of 1 is 1. So we can get the same answer here. So H of 1 is equal to minus H of minus 1 is equal to 0.6366. So next, H of 2 is equal to HD of 2 into WR of 2. Here HD of 2 value is 0. So 0 into 1, 0. H of 3 is equal to HD of 3 into WR of 3 is equal to HD of 3 value is 0.2122, WR of 3 value is 1. So we can get the same answer here. Next, H of 4 is equal to HD of 4 into WR of 4. HD of 4 value is 0. So we can get 0 answer here. H of 5 is equal to HD of 5 into WR of 5. So HD of 5 value is 0.1273 into 1 is equal to the same answer. Okay. Finally, we can obtain the finite impulse sequence H of 0 is equal to H of 2 is equal to H of 4 is equal to 0. h of 1 is equal to minus h of minus 1 is equal to 0.6366. Similarly, we can have h of 3 value is 0.2122, h of 5 value is 0.1273. Okay. The last step in this design process is to obtain the transfer function of the realizable Hilbert transformer. So here this is the formula. Here h of z is equal to z power minus of n minus 1 by 2 into h of 0 plus summation n is equal to 1 to n minus 1 by 2 h of n z power n minus z power minus n. So here for this anti-symmetric filter we can have this minus sign. For symmetric means we can have the plus sign. Okay, remember this formula. Okay, so here we are going to place n is equal to 11 value. So z power minus 11 minus 1 by 2 h of 0 plus summation n is equal to 1 to n minus 1 by 2, that is 11. Okay, then we can get the value as z power minus 5 h of 0 plus summation n is equal to 1 to 5 h of n z power n minus z power minus n. In the next step, we can simply expand this summation. After that, we have to substitute the values of this h of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have already obtained these values in that previous step, right? So we can substitute those values here. Then we can get z power minus 5 of h of 0 value is 0. H of 1 value is 0.6366. Then h of 2 value is 0. H of 3 value is 0.2122. H of 4 value is 0. And then h of 5 value is 0.1273. In the next step, we have to multiply these values inside this bracket. Then we can get that expression like this. And then we have to multiply this z power minus 5 inside this bracket. So here we can get 0.6366. z power 1 is there. Z power minus 5, we can add the powers. So minus 5 plus 1 means z power minus 4. Minus 0.6366 z power minus 1 minus 5. Then we can get minus 6 plus 0.2122. Here z power 3, z power minus 5. So we can get z power minus 2. So similarly, we can get minus 0.2126 z power minus 3, z power minus 5 means z power minus 8. Then here 0.1273 z power plus 5 into z power minus 5. Then we can get the value as z power 0. Z power 0 is nothing but 1. Okay. So next, minus 0.1273 into z power minus 5 into z power minus 5 means z power minus 10. Correct. So we have to write this expression in a proper order because we have to start with a constant term. Correct. So here this is the constant term. So we can start that transfer function like this. So h of z is equal to 0.1273 plus the next smallest number is what? Here 0.2122 z power minus 2. So z power minus 2 is the smallest one. Then only z power minus 4, z power minus 6, z power minus 8, z power minus 10. So this is the final transfer function of the realizable Hilbert transformer. Okay. So from this, we can write the final filter coefficients as 0.1273. That is the constant value. Constant value represents n is equal to 0 value, right? So there is no z power minus 1 term. So we can say that value is 0. Then z power minus 2, here we can say 0.2122. z power minus 3 is not there. We can simply put 0. Z power minus 4 value is here. Z power minus 5 is not there. Simply put 0. And 6 value is there. 7 is not there. We can put 0. Z power minus 8 value, there is no. Z power minus 9. So we can put 0. Finally, minus 0.1273 for this n is equal to 10. Do you all understand? This is the answer.